I'm here with my partner, Andrew Kraus. We've been helping people, inventors, for how many years?
19 going on 20.
Feels like it's forever. Okay, but we're at the National Hardware Show, and what are we doing here?
Walking the show, meeting our students, talking with companies that are interested in products, all that good stuff.
Well, we're learning about the industry, of course, but you know what else? We have a lot of students here, and to hear what's happening, that's what's important to me. Are they getting into companies? What are companies saying? Are they struggling? And we meet with them the second day to go over some of the issues
right. To
make sure that they're going to use this show to be successful. But how many new products have you seen here? Anything exciting?
A ton, yeah. I mean, how many? I don't know. Hundreds?
Yeah, there's a lot of companies here. So if you ever go to these trade shows, there's a lot of value. So Stephen Key, Andrew Kraus, having a good time at InventRight with all our students at the, where are we?
Hardware Show.
All right, thank you.
All right, guess who's here? Terry, what's going on? Why are you at the show?
I am at the show for a variety of reasons. Number one, to meet with a bunch of InventRight students, which is going to be a whole lot of fun. And to, of course, talk to potential licensees, find companies that are open to innovation and accepting of ideas that I'm going to bring to them and hopefully get licensed. So that's the goal.
Okay, Stephen Key here. I always say it, I'm with Judy, one of our coaches at InventRight. Judy, why are you here at the National Hardware Show in Las Vegas? What are you doing here?
I'm here for a couple of my own products, but I'm also here to mentor our students in person, walk with them through the day, walk with them and prepare them in the morning. And we've had really great results, like collecting cards, connections, making great conversation. It's been pretty outstanding.
So how are the companies treating you when you're walking the floor? Are they nice to you? They tell you go away? How are they treating you?
I don't think it's my girl flair, but I think that everybody has been really kind. Everybody has been really kind. They're very curious. What is it that we do? You know, when I kind of describe we work with modern day inventors, they're interested. They're genuinely interested. So I found that is pretty outstanding too. I mean, I love it.
Hey, Stephen Key here. Once again, I have one of our InventRight coaches, Paul. Paul, what are you doing here at the National Hardware Show in Las Vegas?
Getting sore legs.
Are you tired?
Well, we still have a day and a half left, so we can't be tired yet.
How many students of your that you're coaching now, how many are here today?
I'll bet. I dare say 10 to 15.
That's quite a few. And what are you doing? Are you coaching them how to work a show? I know you talk
Absolutely.
To them once a week. Are they having success? Are they having problems? What's going on?
Now, it's pretty cool to talk to them yesterday at the meetup, and I told a bunch of them, come back tomorrow and report to me what your experience was. It's been really cool to have them come back, and almost without fail, they have a great big grin on their face and like, oh my gosh, companies are so open to innovation. Here's this experience. They start telling me their story, and it's been a fabulous experience for them. It's been really good.
You're the guy, he knows everything there is about what? QVC?
QVC, HSN, home shopping. A little bit.
No, he knows all of it. He's an expert. And you're here at the show. What are you doing at the show?
So we have a lot of clients that are here. We'll have meetings with QVC and HSN throughout the week. And then we're also always looking for great new products and new innovations to bring to QVC.
All right, so if you've got a great idea and you're a manufacturer and you want exposure, who's the guy to go to?
Tom Czar.
There you go. Thanks.
Thank you.
Stephen Key here. Guess what? I've got an InventRight student. Andy, thank you for coming to the Hardware Show. What are you doing here? What's going on?
Oh, I love coming to these shows because I learn so much about the industry. See where my ideas might fit in. I get lots of new ideas. And I also get to meet people, make contacts, and see which companies are ready for open innovation.
All right, so these shows are important for you to be there, walk and meet those companies, because you've licensed an idea, but in a different category, right? I mean, it's
totally
not here.
Different. No, not here. But, you know, I think any good inventor is going to want to work in a variety of categories. We want to narrow down so we get to know the people in one area. That's how we're going to be the most successful as inventors. But I still have a lot of interest in a couple different areas, so I do about four different trade shows a year.
All right, that's what you need to do, you guys. Come up with a lot of ideas, go to a lot of trade shows, knock on a lot of doors, and that's how you get the deals done?
That's how it works.
All right, thank you.
I'm Jamie Olson, and I am here at the show to see which companies are open to new products and if they're open to licensing those products. And I'm looking forward to collecting as many cards as I can. Big stack, like Andrew says, big stack.
Hi, I'm Diana, and I'm at the National Hardware Show looking to get some cards of some smaller companies. This is my first show. Really excited.
Hi, I'm Andrew from Calgary, Alberta. I am here at the National Hardware Show with InventRight. I'm going to walk the show. Hopefully, we're going to see lots of vendors and booths and maybe get some cards or a deal if we're lucky.
So you're pitching your ideas. How's it going?
Going great. Yeah, I mean, it's easy. Everyone's friendly. You know, you can walk right in and just start shaking hands and meet new friends and making connections.
Wait, you're telling me they're saying, hey, what are you doing here? But they're being friendly to you while you're pitching ideas?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. They're, you know, everyone's here having a good time, you know, and it's the hardware show. It's, you know.
I just walked the show floor with Andrew's advice and worked with the different vendors, asking marketing manager and how I can get my product into their company. I get strange looks and different reactions, but if they're open to it, they'll tell me they are. If they're not, they'll point me in the right direction. And some are interested, some are not, and some are say, we welcome innovation and bring it to us. Here's my card and tell me what you got. And easy in and out.
You're working it, you're meeting all these CEOs. How are they treating you?
They're very open and very receptive. I was sure to make contact in advance on LinkedIn and kind of felt it out to see if they were receptive to meeting, and most of them said pop on by. So presidents and CEOs and innovation directors have all been really welcoming. It took some footwork beforehand. I spent several hours going through the booths and doing my game plan, but it seems to be paying off.
You're here at the show, second day, you're walking it, you're meeting all these companies. How are they treating you? You get a few no's yesterday?
Yeah, absolutely. We get no's all the time, usually. Very polite no's. People are here to do business, so they understand the conversations that are going to take place. But very often you're going to get a polite no or some kind of rejection. That's fine. That's fine, because you can use information and feedback that you get within those conversations to prepare you for the next one, or in some way to work on your product that you didn't necessarily think of, but now you can go back and maybe adjust your sell sheet to address that particular issue that you learned from somebody in a conversation with them. So it's always great to talk.
Hi there, I'm Kate Myers, and I'm here at the National Hardware Show with Andrew and Steven and a bunch of other students, and this is my second day. Yesterday was great. I met some actual new companies that were open to new product ideas, and I got a bunch of stack of cards, and so it's been definitely worth it, and I'm looking forward to visiting a lot more booths today and get some more cards.
So what was your experience at the show yesterday, Mike?
Oh, it was just awesome. It was quite inspiring. I actually came into this show with some reservations because I had some trouble online with some of the hardware companies, but once I started talking to them in person, it was amazing. I kept track, and 85% of the companies I approached said that they would be open to innovation, and one company, in fact, said that they would be willing to fly me out to their facility to actually present to their entire team. So I was quite encouraged and inspired.
Found some companies yesterday that I planned on, made all the contacts that I felt like I needed, and today I focused on mainly new companies for future ideas, things I'm not working on yet, but even made contacts for those. So once they're developed and once they're, you know, down the pipeline, then I already have the contacts. So it's going great.
The show went great. Got a stack of cards. That was my goal. Of the cards, 11 of them are potential for license opportunities and 5 partnership opportunities. So it went great.
Mike, you're the inventor. What's the name of your product? And let me see the packaging.
Push and hang. This is very simple packaging. The graphics tell the story. Push and hang, the two handles right there, pushing into the wall. And this is so simple. 1, 2, 3 step, and you hang the picture, walk away. Just that quick and easy. Now anybody can use it, so have fun with it. Push and hang.
Inventing ideas is never going to be easy, and you're always going to have some issues, right? You're always going to have some problems. What did you overcome that made this even better for the consumer to use?
Well, when I developed this as push and hang, I also came up with my own proprietary nail. I thought, you know what? A special nail that goes along with the product is going to make a lot of sense, and everybody's going to love it because it attaches to its own product. But what I found out was, in a sense, I actually made a nail that had a little bevel in the center of it, so it actually held the stability of the picture when you hung it. But then I found out, as I go along with all the questions of people, they often ask me, do I have to buy a special nail just to hang a picture on the wall with your product? And after so many people start talking, I thought, wow, maybe that nail isn't going to work out so well being attached to the product. So I went back to a simple number 17 brad nail that you can buy in any store in America or actually across the world and actually use it for level art. So that's how I sort of overcome that, you know. So don't be so attached with, I think, adding products to your thing that's going to make it work is the right way to go. Make sure you ask a lot of questions and make sure you get the right thing that's going to work for your particular product.
Hi, I'm Paula Reinhardt, and I'm at the National Hardware Trade Show with Andrew Cross, and I'm so excited to talk to you today about my new product called the Bagless Vacuum Cleaning Tool. It cleans out your Cyclone Cylinder vacuum in seconds. Basically, what you're going to want to do is pull the hook and pull out the clogged debris and then flip it over and simply go around the canister and it cleans it out in seconds. I'm really excited to be here today.
Hey guys, Dusty Rylands here. Just want to thank Andrew Krause and Stephen Key for all their help. I've been watching their videos for years and read their books. Everything helped me license my deal with Lifetime Brands. My product now is right here at the Hardware Show, and it was at the Chicago Houseware Show a couple months ago. So thank you guys. I couldn't have done it without you guys. So awesome. Thank you.
All right, Stephen Key here, and I'm walking the show. I'm at the National Hardware Show in Las Vegas, and I meet these two guys. I say, hey, you're Stephen Key. And I said, yes. So why are you here? What's your name and why are you here?
I'm Danny Shonskis. I'm with Gig Gear. And this is
Evan Grazzi.
Also and with Gear. We came here, actually, we've already got products that are on the market, but we're looking to move them into a different market. And instead of going the route of potentially trying to take on a very saturated market already, we're looking to license the product or license the name in some way.
And it was what do you know about licensing?
Everything only what you've taught us.
Everything I know about licensing, I know from Stephen Key. Read his books, definitely. Get the newsletter,
one
check out the
idea.
Website, watch the YouTube videos. It's really like a gold mine of information. And I consider myself lucky for having been able to read it, in order to kind of know what to do. And the craziest thing was, I was literally walking earlier and I was saying, this is the kind of show that Stephen Key would be at, or one of his guys. How crazy would it be if we bump into him? I kid you not. I said that about an hour.
Now, did I pay you guys to say that?
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure, Stephen.
Thank you. All right, I'm at the National Hardware Show. I'm talking to inventors, and I have an inventor here that's got a... You got a lot of stuff. What is all this stuff?
Come on, Steve. This is the best new stuff here.
All right, show me one idea.
Listen, we've got the easy throw snow shovel.
Right. Why is that easy?
Because the slits breaks the suction of the snow to the shovel blade, so when you throw it, it flies off. It doesn't hurt your back. It's fun and it's functional. What better product is that?
It's fun, it's functional, it doesn't break your back.
Hey, listen, it's made in America.
I love that. That's how you have to pitch ideas. Now, you watch my video channel or
yes,
not?
I do. Steve is an awesome guy. He's been doing this as long as I have, maybe longer.
Oh!
And listen and follow his videos because he really tells you what you need to know to get from point A to point B. And take your time. Don't go by your passion. You gotta make sure you do your homework and get your product to the market. America is waiting for you, and he's going to help you get there.
Thank you very much.
There you go, Steve. You're awesome.
Okay, I'm here with InventRight student Dave, and he wants to talk. I want to ask him a couple questions about our program. Is it working? Are you getting into the company? Are you benefiting from InventRight?
I am learning a ton. I don't have a yes yet, but I think I'm very close. It's really opened my eyes to a lot of the actual process that needs to take place. Sell sheets have been fantastic.
All right, good.
Coaching's been awesome.
And your coach is Amy Joe?
Amy Joe, yep. Fantastic.
We love Amy Joe. Yeah. She's fantastic. How often are you calling her? Once a week, I hope?
Once a week, yeah. Okay. So, and it's, I've got a lot else going on, so I'm not able to do as much as I would want to, but every time I call, she's right on point. She's got the next step for me, and so she always gives me great homework and keeps me accountable. It's been awesome. And the videos just answer the questions, you know, before they're even asked. So,
good, good. Thank you very much. Enjoy the show.
Thank you.
Walk it, collect all the cards, follow our 10 steps, and if you need us,
thanks so much.
Second day, I'm in Las Vegas at the National Hardware Show. Guess what? I am beat. I am tired. But what did I do? My mission was to find those companies that are looking for ideas for you. So stay tuned. I'm going to post them on the internet. So keep inventing. Go to these trade shows and get your ideas to market by finding those potential licensees. This is Stephen Key.